I thank God for another privilege to be here this morning. He woke us up this morning and we just want to give him thanks and praise. It is no goodness of our own, but because of his grace and his love and his mercy, we are here. And I just want to give him the praise and the glory. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord God, for another opportunity when we can glorify your name. We thank you, Father God, for your many blessings. Father, we thank you that you are mindful of us and you love us with an everlasting love. Father, we thank you this morning for this word. I pray, Lord God, that it would touch somebody this morning who needs this word, Father. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I'm reading this morning from 2 Kings chapter 7, verses 3 to 8. 2 Kings chapter 7, verses 3-8. Now there were four leprous men at the entrance of the gate, and they said to one another, "Why are we sitting here until we die? If we say we will enter the city, the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit here, we die also. Now therefore, come, let us surrender to the army of the Syrians. If they keep us alive, we shall live, and if they kill us, we shall only die." And they rose at twilight to go to the camp of the Syrians. And when they had come to the outskirts of the Syrian camp, to their surprise, no one was there. For the Lord had caused the army of the Syrians to hear the noise of chariots and the noise of horses and the noise of a great army. So they said to one another, "Look, the king of Israel has hired against us the kings of the Hittites and the kings of the Egyptians to attack us." Therefore they arose and fled at twilight and left the camp intact, their tents, their horses, and their donkeys, and they fled for their lives. And when these lepers came to the outskirts of the camp, they went into one tent and ate and drank and carried from it silver and gold and clothing and went and hid them. Then they came back and entered another tent and carried some from there also and went and hid it. The title of this devotion is Change Your Position. Change Your Position. Here in this chapter, we read of four lepers who had been sent out of the city to die, outcasts from society. They had no idea that even though they had been separated from the life they were accustomed to, God would still make a way. This was a time of severe famine. The famine was so great that the people were selling donkeys' heads and dove dung. The famine was so severe that one mother gave up her son to be eaten one day in trust that her neighbor would cook her son the next day. My God, that did not work out as planned. So she complained to the king, but there was nothing that the king could do. What a dire situation for these four lepers. Severe famine and cast out of the city. These four men were dying of leprosy, dying of starvation. The law stated that because of their condition, they had to stay outside of the city. Although it seemed like they were all alone and dying, God was recalculating their position. Whatever situation you are in this morning, God is recalculating your position. God is showing you a way out if you would only let go of the fear of failure. These men said, "Why are we sitting here until we die? If we say we will enter the city, the famine is in the city and we shall die there. And if we sit here, we die also. So let us just surrender to the Syrians, the army of the Syrians. And if they keep us alive, we will live. And if they kill us, we shall only die." These lepers decided we will not stay here and do nothing. If we die, we will die trying to live. There are some people, because of their situation, they have already given up. They are probably saying, "What's the sense of trying?" Some say, "Whatever will be, will be." Some say, "Maybe this is God's plan for me to sit here and die." Let me tell you today, God is showing you a different way. Change your position. the time must come when you make a choice, regardless of the position you are in. And in spite of the enemy who wants to destroy you, make a choice. When Moses and Israelites came to the Red Sea, Moses told the Israelites, the Red Sea is before us. Excuse me. The Egyptians are behind us, but we are going forward. Somebody might say, going forward through the sea? Did Moses lose his mind? No. Moses heard God. When God says go forward, change position, forget about the Pharaoh and his chariots and his horsemen. Raise your hand to the God who has given you direction and move forward. Move forward because you heard God. Move forward because God is with you. Move forward because your move will take you where God will bless you. Keep going forward because God will part the Red Sea. Keep going forward. Don't look back because God will destroy the enemy. God has separated you for a blessing. Trust his voice and do not sit there until you die. There was a great army camped outside, ready to invade Samaria. These lepers had three choices: enter the city, stay outside of the city, or surrender to the Syrians. The famine that they had left in the city would kill them. The leprosy in their bodies would kill them. So if they went to the Syrian army, they may be kept alive, or the worst thing that could happen would be death. Sometimes one step of faith causes God to make a way. In other words, it can't get any worse than this. We can't just sit here and die. We have to make a move. Verse 5 says, and they rose at twilight to go to the camp of the Syrians. And when they had come to the outskirts of the camp of the Syrians, to their surprise, no one was there. For the Lord had caused the army of the Syrians to hear the noise of chariots and the noise of horses, the noise of a great army. It was so great that they said, look, the king of Israel has hired other kings to come and attack us. These lepers had no chariots. They didn't have any horses. They were just four half-dead men walking toward the Syrian camp. Don't you think the army would know the difference between the sound made by weak lepers walking and the sound of horses and chariots? But the Lord had caused them to hear the noise of chariots and horses. The Lord had caused it. God is so amazing. The Syrians heard the sound of horses and chariots, and they thought that the king of Israel had joined forces with the greatest armies on the earth to fight them. In fear, they escaped for their lives, leaving even their own horses. God will put your enemy to flight when you decide, I am casting all my cares upon the Lord. I'm not looking back, and I am going forward. I refuse to go back to the famine. I will not sit here and die. I will make a move to go forward. God has separated me to bless me, and I will receive my blessing. Let me repeat that for somebody this morning. Nothing will stop your blessing because God has separated you to bless you, and you will receive your blessing if you make up in your mind, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, to cast all your cares upon him. As I walk, God will make my feet like hinds' feet and set me upon my high places. I may look like I am cast aside, but God has me seated with him in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I will continue to move forward, even if God has to disguise me, to hide me from the enemy. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. By my God, the scripture says, I run through troops and leap over walls. If only we would recognize who we are in Christ Jesus and what God can do just because he is awesome and because he loves us. Those bad days are behind you. The famine is behind you. And though they may have cast you aside, God is making roads in the wilderness and streams in the desert. You may not see him. You may not feel him, but he's right there. Ask him to open your eyes to see what he is doing, how he is moving on your behalf. Verse 7 tells us the army of the Syrians fled their camp, leaving their tents, their horses, and their donkeys, and they fled for their lives. Isn't God awesome? When we make a move, the enemy will flee. As children of the Most High God, we have to let the devil know enough is enough. I am trusting God. Devil, you will not hold me captive any longer. I will move forward in the name of the Lord. The scripture says the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. Just picture the enemy running from you this morning because you choose to advance by faith. When the lepers came to the outskirts of the camp, they went into one camp, one tent. They ate and they drank, and they took silver and gold and clothing from that camp, and they went and they hid them. Then they came back and they entered into another tent, and they carried some from there also, and they went and they hid it. God makes the impossible possible for us. And when God blesses, he blesses in abundance. These lepers had enough and to spare. They went into the city to spread the good news of the things that they had found. Nobody chased them back outside them. When you are in need, God is the one you least expect to bless you. So be careful who you reject. Be careful who you cast aside. Be careful who you turn your back on, because they may be the very ones God will choose to bless you. Hallelujah. When they are walking in their abundance. This morning, somebody feels separated, cut off, left out. But God is about to bless you in the midst of your separation. You may have been separated from people. You may have been separated from people and places, but your position has changed so that you can be blessed. Take one step of faith, and God will cause things to change in your favor. Don't sit there saying, I am in need of this and I am in need of that, but you have not made a single move to get it. You may not understand why you have been separated, but look at Abraham, look at Esther, look at the three Hebrew boys, look at John on the Isle of Patmos, and so many others who were separated to be a blessing to others. God is recalculating your position, and you have been separated to receive a blessing that is beyond your comprehension. Hallelujah. And will not only be for you, but for others. Get up and make a move. Change your position. Hallelujah. I just heard the Lord say, change your position, because you are looking at things on a natural level. But trust me to lift you up on a higher level where you can see things from heavenly places, because that's where you are seated with him in heavenly places. Things look different when you look from up down. They even look smaller than when they are on eye level. I don't know who that is for this morning. Hallelujah. God, I thank you this morning for your word. Thank you for your presence. I thank you for speaking to us, God. The songwriter says, Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's tableland. A higher plane than I have found, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Help us to change our position this morning, Father. Help us not to look at things with the natural eye, for the things that we see are subject to change, and the things that we do not see Father God, they are eternal. They are working for us a far more eternal weight of glory. Father, bless Joy Gospel Radio FM family this morning. Keep your hand on Evangelist Burns this morning, Father God. Cause her to hear you, Lord God, and to walk in your ways only. Bless us together, I pray, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you this morning, God. I give you praise. In Jesus' name, the Lord bless you.